Hey, what's up, folks? This is BQ with the Impact Lounge. Please hit that subscribe button. Not sure how many of you caught this. I haven't been online a whole heck of a lot lately. Just really, really, really busy. But I kind of feel like this news didn't really get out there the way that it needed to. And I haven't really seen something official, like on the Impact Twitter or anything like that. But several of the dirt sheets ran it. And then I saw the video from the actual One Night Only show, where the ring announcer had said it. But what he had said is that in June, I believe June 1st and 2nd, they're going to be running two nights of tapings for Impact. They just wrapped up the One Night Only show with BCW. It was a sold out crowd. And if you don't know what the final attendance was, it was about 900 people. So 900 paid fans came and sold the place out. And a lot of people were saying, like, man, I really hope they do a pay-per-view there, or I hope they do Impact there. So it seems like they are doing Impact. It's going to be two nights of tapings, 1 month of television. So it's not going to be like right now where we're watching 12 straight weeks of television from one taping. We know that the Redemption pay-per-view is April 22nd. There's going to be tapings after that, which to me, I don't remember how many days they're doing, but if my math serves me correctly, I believe it's going to be about 6 weeks of tapings, which is fine. You know, when they do 4 weeks, 6 weeks, which they've done a few times, I think that's where the television is a lot more focused. And we don't have to go through what we are right now, where we're seeing EC3 and Lashley and Laurel and God knows who else, Hanaya. You know, people no longer with the company, and we're kind of sitting through that every week. So when they're able to do the shorter block of tapings, it's a lot more entertaining. They did something similar to this last year. I think it was June, because Slammiversary was in July, I think, where they did the month of tapings, the two nights in India. So now it seems like this year they're going to do those two nights in Windsor, Ontario, and a whole month of taping. So I don't know that it's going to be the sold out crowd, but you know, based off the One Night Only show, and they're only asking people to do two nights, and that's where it really differs from doing the Impact Zone in Orlando, is that if they do 4, 5, 6 nights of tapings, I mean, you're asking a lot from people to come every single night to the show. So, and also the Impact Zone is very inconvenient as far as parking and getting to the actual Impact Zone, total pain in the ass. And then you got to pay pretty hefty parking fee there in Universal. So this is badass. This should make for a pretty good television. I don't think it's going to be, you know, 900 people in the crowd, but I have to believe it's going to be quite a bit larger than the Impact Zone in Orlando, because, you know, again, they're only asking for the commitment for two nights, and the packages are going to be for the two nights. So people are going to buy individual tickets. So the hope is if you show for the first night, you're showing up for the second night too, because you paid for it. So this is going to be good television, I think. And I think it's going to lead to a really strong Slammiversary build. So last year's Slammiversary build was pretty good because there was a largely energetic India crowd. But the problem was they weren't able to bring Scott Steiner out there and Angelina Love and Alicia and people who had high profile matches on the pay-per-view. So it was kind of a funny build. Yeah, it wasn't the best build in the world for those reasons. This time around, it's close to Michigan, and I was looking at my analytics. I got a lot of listeners in Michigan. That's probably one of my top 6 or 7 states of listeners. So maybe that's a pretty good hotbed for Impact Wrestling. You know, whether it's people coming over the border, and you know, or obviously on the Canadian side of the border, it seems like people really appreciate the product. So this should be really, really fun. Can't wait for it, and can't wait to hear more. See if there's a future announcement regarding it. Thanks for listening, folks. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.